Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the 5 days online course on R programming for data analyst. I am Hiren Kakkar. I'll be your trainer for this program. So I hope I am audible. If I'm audible, then please write yes in the chat box so that I can, have your feedback on that. Okay, thank you for the confirmation. Now we are going to start our session. So what we are going to do is, I'll be completing the topic, and at the end of the topic, I'll ask you to post your queries or to the chat box, and then we'll discuss your queries, right? So let's get started. I'm super excited to start the session. So let me just start the session. So, I'll start with the brief introduction about our company. So anyone who is attending our program for the first time, so it will be new for them. Otherwise, it may be a little repetition for those who already attended our program. So, but that is the protocol that we have kept. Like all the training programs shall start with the company introduction. So I'll take 5-7 minutes to explain about our company so that you can have idea that what we are doing and how we are doing it. So our company State Modeler is formed in 2019, and we are providing services related to the data science and other operational excellence concepts and all. Basically, idea behind this company was to, provide the solution to the people who are looking their data to analyze. Because anyone who is working in either industry or in the research area or any problem solving, they might be collecting several data. So they are dealing with the data. But majority of the people, they are facing the problem of which technique to be used and how it is supposed to be used to solve that problem or to solve that, to prove that research objective or to improve the processes. So that was the, major challenge that I found during my career or during my, when I was working in the industry. And at that time it was observed, these are the challenges which is faced by the industries. So by having that idea in mind, we establish a company called State Modeler so that we can provide that solution wherever they are finding the challenges related to the, right selection of tools and technique to analyze the data. At that time, we are helping them. So major, we are having four domains for the service. The first is data science. The second one where we are providing business transformation solutions. We are also helping research. We are also sharing our expertise in the research project. And we are also getting associated with the training institutes and the colleges and the universities to conduct several programs. So let me just scratch in each of the domain a little bit. So in data science, we are providing training as well as consultancy. So it is not only training. We are also taking assignment of all these services. So in that, we are providing training and consultancy related to the machine learning, R, RStudio, Python, SAS, SPSS, Minitab, Excel, Advanced Excel, Power BI, Tableau. So there are so many tools. So under the umbrella of data science, whatever tools and techniques are there, for that we are providing training and consultancy. Another is business transformation to the industry. So in that we are providing training and consultancy related to the Six Sigma, Lean, 5S, Kaizen, Kanban, statistical process control, statistical quality control, and there are many more. So basically it is not just a concept that we are implementing at the client place. We are customizing the concept. So any of the client place, it is required a mixture of Six Sigma and Lean. So there, that fusion we are creating. Somewhere it is, required like SPC plus 5S plus 6 Sigma. So that all we are combining. Somewhere it is required total productive maintenance, TPM. So that all we are doing. And then we create a customized approach for the business transformation. So it is not only limited to this concept. So it will be a fusion of this concept concepts as per the requirement at the client place. The third area where we are working is research project, where many of the projects are government sponsored, many of the projects are university sponsored, many of the projects are, let's say, individual interest of area. So in that, they basically stuck up with the, when it comes to the data. So they are having their objective to prove during this research. But they mainly stuck up with what type of data to be collected, from where to collect, how much sample to be taken. Once data is collected, how can we validate those data? What are the validity tools that we should apply on this? Then what are the tools and techniques that we are supposed to apply to prove our objective? So these are the challenges basically they are facing. So in that, we are helping them. Many of the people conducting survey and they want analysis of that survey. So in that also, we are sharing our expertise. Many of the companies, they do marketing research to launch their product or to make their marketing strategy. So in that also, we are helping them. So if somebody has conducted marketing research survey that they want to launch product in some particular region, then what type of data to be collected and how to analyze the data. And ultimately, we are creating a report and give our recommendation that in this area, you should have this much of, price range. This would be the product characteristics, that kind of things that we are helping them. The fourth is universities and the institutes. So we are conducting all these programs for the students also. So in that we are associating with university and conduct workshop training programs and certification courses for the student. Mainly our expertise is on R, Python, SAS, SPSS, Minitab, Power BI, Tableau, Excel, and many more. Now we are having our client in different domains, like agroeconomics, agrobusiness management, dairy economics, home science, mechanical engineering, pharmaceutical sciences, financial management, management study, business studies, marketing management, library science. So these are all different domains. And there are many more. If we talk about the industry, then there are many more, like manufacturing industry, service industry. So that type of industries are there where I worked when I was working with my previous organization. So these are the domain where we have either provided training or we have provided the consultancy. So these are the, you can see the varieties of the domain that we touched upon. And as far as statistics or the data analysis is concerned, you'll get this kind of opportunity to touch each and every, subject domain. Like if you're having expertise in the data science or the statistical analysis, because I don't know anything about agroeconomic, but I know statistical tools and technique, or I know this data analysis part. So the domain knowledge will be with the team, and then we understand those things from them, and then we convert their problem into the statistical problem. Then we find out the statistical solution, and again we'll discuss with them and convert that statistical solution to the business solution. So this is the approach that we are following. These are some of the snaps where we provided training and workshop. So this was training on basics of SPSS at BVM College of Engineering. This is a workshop on role of SPSS in research at DDU Nadiad. So Dharam Singh Desai University was there. So there we provided this training. This is 3 days workshop we conducted at Department of Statistics, Sardar Patel University, on basics of Python. So it was 3 days workshop over there. 40 plus students were there. And then in the same department, we also conducted one workshop on Base SAS. So SAS is a statistical analysis software, which is highly used in the pharmaceutical domain. So these are all statisticians, future statisticians, because they are MSc students. So for them, they can choose, whether they want to go into the pharma domain or some other domain. So at that time, this SAS is used. So there we conducted 2+1 days, yani total 3 days ka workshop humne kiya tha. So in 2 days, we explained the theory part and we, done some exercises and all that, how SAS is working. And in 1 day, there was a gap between 2 and 1 day. So there is a gap of 1 week. During that week, we have given them a project, practical project along with the data and all. And then we asked them to present as if they are, presenting to the management. So by analyzing those data, what they feel, what is their recommendation? Because when they go into the industry, at that time, they have to explain like that only. So that kind of practice we performed over there. So it can, add values to the student's knowledge. And these are another snaps where we conducted various programs at Mumbai University. There we provided training on R. We have also provided training in AERC, Agroeconomic Research Center. Then FDP programs, faculty development programs are held by the SPU. Sardar Patel University, that is also held by the Gujarat University, that is also held by the Charuset University, Changa. So there we are going as a faculty. So these are the some of the snaps of it. Now, you are going to spend 5 days with me. So you must know who is your trainer and what is his background. So that is why I kept this little introduction about myself. My name is Hiren Kakkar. I am CEO and co-founder of this company called Stat Modeler. Previously, I was working with one management consulting company, and there I worked for more than 8 years, and then I started my own venture. I am certified Lean Six Sigma Black Belt. I am also certified auditor for ISO 9001. I have trained more than 4,000 people till date on different topics. Till date, I have guided 100 plus improvement project in the industry. I have assisted 25 plus research project, and I'm trainer for R, Python, SPSS, Minitab, Power BI. So these are all the concepts for which I'm imparting the training. So this is little information about me. So now I request you to introduce yourself in the chat box, whether you are professor in some industry, some department, or let's say you are data analyst, or you are a software developer. So what is your background? And in a single line, I want to know what is your expectation from this program. Because if I know your expectation, then only I'll be able to align this program. So anyway, this content is there. But if I know some of the things, then I can align somewhere if it is required. So I request you to please introduce yourself in the chat box. Okay, Swapnil ji is from the China. Currently, he is working there. Yes, everyone, I request you to introduce yourself in the chat box so that we can move ahead. Yes, Saurabh ji is a research scholar in IIT Mandi. Research on weather prediction on Northwest Himalayan region. Correct. Okay. Yes, Mehul. The Rishabh ji, yes. So MSA statistics students in Nainital, it's great. Yes, Sunil ji is senior SQL developer from Pune, India. That's great. So it will be very much easy for you to understand the syntaxes and all. But anyway, we will be starting from the scratch, because this is for the beginner also. So we're starting from the scratch. Swapnil ji is looking for the application of data science and increasing compliances and data integrity as per requirement of 21 CFR. So I may not be able to, I'm not knowing this 21 CFR, but definitely this data science part that we are going to touch upon, because this program is related to that. So you can correlate with your scenarios. Whenever we are learning the techniques, at that time you can correlate with that. And if it is required, then you can discuss with me also. Rohit ji, your introduction is pending, I suppose. Yeah, it is there. Sorry, I missed that. Message. He's a chemical engineer working at an agrochemical group. Will be pursuing MBA in energy management from NTPC School of Business, Noida. I expect to learn R as it will be helpful in data analysis to me in the future. Sure, definitely. So we are going to, you know, start from the scratch and how this R is going to be helpful to us. So that thing we are going to see now. Thank you for your introduction. Let us move ahead in the session. I'm making Mehul. Mehul is one of my team members. So I'm just, you know, making him a co-host. So if is there any technical glitches so that he can, you know, convey it to me. So I'm making him co-host. Mehul, you can, let's say if there is technical problem, you can just talk to me. Right. Unmute yourself and you can talk to me. Right.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. Yeah.
So today what we are going to see, so let us have a look at the agenda of day one. So in day one, we'll be covering like what is R, what is R Studio, then how to download and install this. So already I have sent the video about this, but anyway, like I'll be sharing some of the link during this. We are not going to download and install during the session to save the time. But if you are, if anybody is having any problem during downloading and installation, please just reach out to me on my WhatsApp number. So yeah, or you can post in the group also. Interface of the R and R Studio, that both thing, both the things we are going to see, like when you open R at that time, what are the screen that you are seeing and what those screen are, what are the names of those screen and what are the uses of those screen. So that we are going to see. We'll also see how can we create a new project or new file in R Studio, and how to, you know, set the working directory, or how can we get the current working directory, because working directory is one of the, you know, major, you can say it is a time saving booster it can be, because once you set your working directory at that time, you know, access to the file from that folder becomes very easy. So that we are going to see. And we'll also see what are the data types in R. So every language has their own data types, and majority of them are, sorry, you can say it is common. And some of the nomenclatures are there here and there. So that we'll see what R supports as a R supports as a data types, and what is data structure in R. So one is data type, another one is data structure. So that both, what is the difference between them, and what are those in R that we are going to see. And then at last, we'll have a session wrap up where we just touch upon the topics that we had covered. And then we'll close the session and we'll meet tomorrow. Now, if we explore the Now, let us explore simplicity of R. So in any of the programming language, whenever you start learning it, at that time the first program usually our trainer taught to us as Hello World program. In any of the language, that is what I have observed. So let's say if I want to write down this program in C++, then how am I supposed to write it down? So I have to write down like this. So this pound sign and then include and then IOStream, I have to mention in that greater than and less than equal to sign, and then using a namespace standard, and then integer I have to define, then main. So that this is the coding to just, you know, write the program of Hello World. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 lines of code you need to write down to generate or create a Hello World program. In Java, if you want to write down this program, then these are 5 lines that you need to, you can say, write it down to create a Hello World program. In C#, you need to write down this much of line, like using a system, then namespace, and then class. And you have to also take care of these curly brackets because it is very sensitive over there. So that is the requirement, right? But let's say if in R, if I want to write down in our this R, it is as simple as that. We simply write it down Hello World and then it will print Hello World. So this is the simplicity of R. So no doubt this all languages are having their own benefits, pros and cons, or their advantages and limitations. But when we are comparing with, you know, with respect to this kind of simplicity, then we can say in R it is very easy to manage, right? Now, everyone is having, you know, this question in their mind that why we should learn R. So, by doing research and by my experience, I have mentioned 11 reasons that motivates anyone to, you know, go for the R. So, these are the reasons that you might be feeling that, okay, we are at the right place, or like we are on the right track to learn the R. So, first thing is R is open source and free. So, you don't need to spend single penny in R. So, R is open source. So, anyone can use. It is lifetime free. So, there is no any hidden charges or no any recurring charges or one-time charges. There is nothing like that. Whatever you need to invest, that is in the learning of it. So, you don't need to spend on that purchasing software, but you can, you know, use that software for the free. And then you can spend some of money, or you can say some of the time in learning that language. So that is why it is most likely by everyone. It's very easy to learn for the non-programmer also. So if somebody is having, you know, question in their mind, R is a programming language, then how can we learn that? Because I never learned this C or C++ or any other language. Then will I be able to learn R? So the answer is yes, you'll be able to learn R, if even if you are not programmer or you don't know any languages, C or C++, no requirement of that, because it is very easy to learn. If I give my example, then I also don't have any background of this programming languages. So I never learned this C or C++ or Java or any other language. I started learning R. R is my, you know, first language that I started learning. So it's very easy to learn. So that is the second thing which motivate anyone to, you know, learn or go for the R. And there is a huge community support. So if you, you know, do some programming in R and you find some difficulty or some, you get some error, at that time there is a huge community support is there who can give you the answer or who can, you know, provide you the support. So that is, you know, within, let's say if you post your query to this community support portal, then you'll get maximum by within a 24 hour, you'll get your query resolved. So there are so many people who are working in this community or working in the R. So they are helping everyone who is, you know, beginners, or we can say it is a novice. So they help them out. So that is another, you know, key point which attracts everyone, that agar main ye seekhna start karta hun, then if I stuck up somewhere, then there is community to support us, right? So that is third reason where anyone can go for this R. The fourth reason is there are more than 15,000 packages are available for free. Now, what is package? That we'll discuss, but we'll discuss in detail. But what is package? Package is nothing but a predefined algorithm or some functions or the steps for the analysis purpose. So, for example, if someone want to solve that transportation problem. So somebody is doing, let's say, studying MSc in or MTech in this transportation. So they want to, you know, solve their problem using some transportation algorithm. Then there are several dedicated packages are available for the to deal with that kind of data. If somebody is, you know, doing design of experiment kind of thing. So at that time also there are several packages which they can use. So, and these packages are, you know, more than 15,000 packages, and they are keep on adding on this, you know, packages. Like, for example, if I find some, you know, some of the functions which are not available in R, what I can do as a R user, I can create my own package and put it into the repository of R. Then everyone will be able to use that package. So that kind of thing is happening daily, and every you know, like daily, or you can say weekly, there's these packages are getting increased. And those all packages are available for free. Hardly, you know, few of the packages that might be, you know, commercial. Otherwise, every package is freely available. So you don't need to invest into that also. So that is the fourth feature or reason that anyone can go for this R. It is having highly statistical computing ability. So if you are having, you know, if you want to perform some highly statistical or complex analysis, then many times Excel or some conventional softwares may have some limitation of with respect to that particular program or the features of the statistical analytical tool. But in R, there is a high statistical computing ability over there. So you can use any of the, you know, tool which is available in the statistics through R. And R also supports, you know, your own algorithm. So for example, readily function is not available, but you have your own logic or formulas. So you can convert it into the R program. So that is very easy to handle in that case. So you can easily customize that thing. But let's say if you go for some software like Minitab and the SPSS and the Stata, so in that you cannot customize that, right? So you have to use whatever algorithm is given. So no doubt it is also rich, but when you want to customize, then it is difficult to customize in that. But here it is very easy to customize your own logic and algorithm. It is having very attractive packages for graphics or graphical analysis like ggplot2 and the Plotly. So we'll be touching upon just ggplot2, and we'll just use one of the function of Plotly also, because Plotly is also one of the very big package, and that is developed based on the JavaScript onto it. And we are going to see how can we make beautiful charts using ggplot2 package. So whatever, you know, charts that you might be seeing which is generated by R, that majority of the graphs are generated by this ggplot2 package. So it is nothing but a grammar of graphic. So very informative and very attractive packages there. We'll go into the detail of it at the last day of the session. And it is also compatible for the machine learning. So like if someone wants to, you know, use the machine learning algorithms, at that time also it will be supported by R. So there are several packages which you can use to develop use machine learning algorithm. Like in Python, there is a library called sklearn or scikit-learn. So that is used for the machine learning. So similarly here, there are several packages which you can use for the machine learning. It is having very strong IDE like RStudio. IDE means what? Integrated Development Environment. So basically what it does, so IDE, you know, save you a lot of time in doing some repetitive task, or, you know, some like here and there when you use that row R, at that time you need to, you know, have some limitations to use it. There is no suggestion kind of thing over there. But in RStudio, all the things are available. So ultimately, any IDE, what is the role of IDE? So IDE boost up the productivity of the programmer. So here for R, the IDE is RStudio. And that is very powerful. You can manage many of the things within that, you know, RStudio only. So that is plus point of it. However, in Python, there are, you know, several IDEs options are available, like PyCharm is there, Jupyter is there, Spider is there, Visual Code is there, Orange is there. So there are so many IDEs are available in that. So many of the time beginners may confuse. Even when I started learning Python, at that time I was also confused that which IDE I supposed to use as a beginner. But here there is no confusion, because RStudio is only the, you can say, IDE for R. No doubt you can, you know, attach in some other IDEs, but 98% of the people are using RStudio along with R. The ninth reason is it is also useful for the web application. So however, this web application is not the part of the syllabus, but if time permits, I'll also show some of the, you know, applications which I developed using Shiny and Plex dashboard package. So if time permits, I'll show it to you. We'll not go into the detail of it, but I'll show that what extent you can take this R programming. And it is used in almost every industry. So it is, there is no nothing like that ki R sirf ye industry ke liye hai, hamare liye kaam ka nahi hai. It is not like that. It can be used in every industry. It can be used in the research, it can be used in the process industry, it can be used in the IT industry, it can be used in a like manufacturing industry. So everywhere it can be used. And it is having a cross-platform compatibility. What do we mean by this cross-platform compatibility? So it is available for Windows, Linux, Unix, Mac. So for all this, it is available. And another thing is you can also connect it with the SQL or the Spark server. So, you know, there is a cross-platform things are there. So you can also even some of the packages are there. If you use those packages, then you can connect it with the this JSON file, and then this, you know, APIs. You can connect it with the APIs. You can also connect it with the, like, what you can say, your server, jo hamara server hota hai company ka, that also you can connect it with that. So that kind of cross-platform compatibility is there. Also, you can, you know, use Python files into this RStudio. So there are several packages. So for that also, you can use Python files here in the RStudio also. So that kind of, you know, flexibility is there. So that will, you know, attract the people to learn this language. Now, let us move ahead. Like, what are, like, as a, when we are learning something at our own, at that time, there might be, you know, another question in our mind, that what are the career opportunities in the art, like whatever we are learning. So here I just few days back, because I was having one webinar in one university. So at that time I collected this data. So I just searched career opportunity in R programming. So I had that location in Mumbai. So let me just go to this website or this search so that we can have idea that what are the immense number of opportunities are there. Let me just copy and paste it over here so that you can have a, you know, idea about it. So let me open this. So you can see here, when I search career opportunity in R programming in Mumbai, you can change the location and add your location also. So these are the, you know, posts which are available. So you can see it is around 1 month ago it was done. So this is, let's say, 7 days ago it was posted over there in Mumbai. This is, let's say, 1 month, 1 month, then 14 hours ago, this data scientist in analytics Vidya. So you can see there are so many opportunities are there. So these are the, you know, Python, R, and then this data science. These are the now a buzzword, and there is a huge opportunities are there. So you can also explore these areas. You can also apply for this if you are interested to, you know, build your career in R programming or the data science. So you can also go for this. Now question is there, like, what are the salary packages that we might be getting? There are, you know, so many opportunities, but what will be the salary package? So I also collected some of the information regarding that. So let me just go to the presentation. Is my screen visible?
Yes, it is visible.
Okay, thank you. Now, I also mentioned the sources over here so that you can also go and verify whether these figures are correct or not. So Dataflight Training is there. So they are conducting this kind of surveys to know what is the fact and figures. So they conducted one survey related to the R careers, and they found, like, what are the different designations are there. So data scientist, business analyst, data analyst, then this data visualization expert, quantitative analysis, and what are the salary packages over there. So they also, you know, collected salary data of those personnel, the professionals, and they mention over there, this is average salary packages are this much of, like, so for example, if some experienced data scientist is there, then the package is 28 lakh. Business analyst, 6,70,000. Data analyst, 7,20,000. So these are the average packages over there. And that might be, you know, changing. So a few months back, this might be executed over there. Then I also search on this pay scale, because we are the Six Sigma people. So in Six Sigma, we used to tell whatever you need to claim, that you need to claim with the data. So we collect data first and then we form a statement, right? So here I have also collected data from the payscale.com. So they are also collecting data of this different domains. So where I search, like, what is the average salary of the R programmer or the personnel who are having the R skill in India. So you can see, on an average salary is 7,25,000, and you can also visit this site to, you know, get more detail about this. You can see these are the different, you know, like, job title over there: data scientist, data analyst, analytics manager, and then this senior data analyst. So you can see, again, average packages are also over there. You can also visit this site to see these figures. These figures are updated on a regular basis. So whenever you visit this, you'll find the latest information over there. So this I did few days back. And if you see the salary package distribution among the country, and continent, then you can find out this chart, which is very useful chart. You can say there is a this Africa, Americas, and then Asia and Europe and Oceania are there, and then these are the countries: US, Israel, Norway, Switzerland, Denmark, Australia, UK, Canada, Germany, Ireland, New Zealand. Likewise, countries are there, and this box plot shows the salary package over there. So highest salary package is in the US. There it is, somewhere around, you can say, you can just match it up this line over there, then you may find it is somewhere around 110 annual this USD salary, 1,10,000 USD as an annual salary over there. You can find out India over somewhere here. So it is there. So you can see there is a huge potential over there, because in India now this data science and this business intelligence and these fields are just emerging field. So there is a huge potential over there in the India. So if you learn all these things at this stage, then it will be very much helpful for you to build your career or enhance your career in this particular domain. So this also you can see in this link. And this graph is made itself in R. So this graph was built in the, you can say, ggplot2 package, which I was talking about. So this graph was built in that. So these are the power of R, you can say. Now, what are the companies that they are using the R? So many of the companies which are known to us, like Facebook, and then Bharti AXA, then Accenture, and then this Standard Chartered Bank, and then IBM, Oracle, Deloitte, Amazon, TCS, Google. So these are the companies which are using this R as a programming language in their organization. So there may be chances, if someone is really interested to go in this domain, then they can also approach this type of industry when they are ready with the skills. Now, that was why people should go for this R, and that kind of stuffs were there. So that was very essential or the important before starting the actual session of the R. Now we'll jump into the introduction of R. So here you can see R is a programming language, so which provides an environment for the statistical computing and the graphic. So what is the difference between programming language and the software? So basically, softwares are nothing but they are menu driven, right? So you have to go in the this menu, then click over there, then select this function, then add your data over there, and then click OK. You'll get the output. So for example, if I give you a simple example, then in Excel, what we are doing, if you want to make a bar chart, for example, so we have a data, we go to the insert menu, we go to select the chart, then we select the data, and then just click OK. At that time, bar chart will be appeared there. If we want to change color, we can just right click on the bars, and then we can change the colors and all, right? So that is the software. So basically, software is a menu driven. But whenever we talk about the programming language, so the programming language is a syntax based. So there you need to write down the syntaxes. Syntaxes means the codes. So if I want my bars color to be red, so I have to mention that color is equal to red, or whatever argument it is taking. So it depends on the programming language which you are using, but you have to mention there in the words like color is equal to red, then your bars will be red. There is no option to right click on the bars and then you can change the colors and all. So that is the, you can say, a difference between programming language and the software. You can say it is similar to the S language, which was developed by Bell Laboratories earlier. So if anyone is familiar with the S language, however, I have not used it, but the experts are telling that S language is quite similar to the R, or R is quite similar to the S language. And R provides a wide variety of statistical. It may be linear, it may be non-linear. So that kind of modeling are there in the statistics. So for that also, R provides, that frameworks or the packages. It can also provide supports to this statistical test, hypothesis test, and all that. If you want to perform that, we can perform in the R. We can also perform time series analysis, so that is also possible in R. We can also perform classification, like in machine learning there is a technique called classification, so that also we can perform in the R. Then we can also go for the unsupervised learning, clustering kind of thing. That is also possible in R. and there are, you know, several graphical techniques and packages are available, like base package. Like base package is what? That is R's inbuilt package. So R जब install करते हैं तो उसके साथ ही उसका package जो आता है वो base package बोलते हैं. तो वो बेस पैकेज भी बहुत ही स्ट्रॉन्ग है इसका ग्राफिकल के लिए. प्लस ggplot2 इज देयर, lattice इज देयर, देन plotly इज देयर. फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू वांट टू गो फॉर सम दिस हिट मैप एंड वर्ल्ड मैप काइंड ऑफ थिंग, देन हाई चार्टर इज देयर. सो देयर आर सेवरल पैकेजेस आर अवेलेबल व्हिच सपोर्ट्स द आर टू मेक योर यू नो ग्राफिकल प्रेजेंटेशन, एंड दैट इज आल्सो हाईली एक्सटेंसिबल. एंड again, but and a small repetition. So R is available as a free under the terms of Free Foundations of GNU's public license from the source code, and it compiles and runs on the wide variety of Unix platform and similar systems, including FreeBSD and Linux. So maybe technical people might be, you know, able to correlate this, but as a user, this with respect to this last line, it is not that much important for us. So हमारे लिए क्या काम का है कि हमारी जो सिस्टम है, either it is Windows or Mac or Linux, so it should work on that. Now another question that also might be a curious question, that why it is called R? Why not Z? Why not, let's say, X? Why not Q? Why not P? Why it is called R? So is there anyone who knows that what is the reason behind this? So you can mention in the chat box if you know the reason. Yes, Saurabh ji has got that answer, because of the developers. Yeah. So let me just show it to you. So these are the two people, Robert Gentleman and Rose Ehaka. So you can see their first name is start with the R, Robert and Rose. So you know that's why it is called R. And both the gentlemen are from the University of Auckland in New Zealand. So they developed this R language, and this name was given just because of that. Their initials are starting from R. Now let us go to this introduction to R Studio. So हमने थोड़ा R के बारे में देखा कि R क्या है, किसने develop किया था, वो कैसे काम करता है. अभी थोड़ा सा हम बात करते हैं R Studio के बारे में. And then we'll open both this windows and then we'll see what is it's called. So जैसे R open source है, similarly R Studio is also open source, freely available for everyone, and there is a you know commercial license is also available. So if any organization they want to go for the commercial version, then also that pro version is available for R Studio as well as R Studio server, so that both the facilities are available. But for an individual user, it is available for free. So we are using that free version, because whatever feature that they are giving in the R Studio, that is sufficient for us to use. R Studio is an integrated development environment. So as I mentioned, that it is IDE for R. It is available for desktop and server edition. Desktop mein, it is available for Windows, Mac and Linux. For server as of now it is for the Linux only. So server ke liye agar aapko R Studio use karna hai, then you have to go for the Linux only. Now how can we download and install R and R Studio? So the link is there, which I already forwarded during the video. So download R from this cran.r-project.org. So the current version of R available is 4.0.0. That is the latest version available for the R. And you can also download this R Studio from this its official website, rstudio.com, and there you can find out this product and R Studio and then download. And if you want to, you know, go for some older version, like this is required 64 bits of system. But if you don't have that 64 bits of system and you want to, or sometime it happen, like in even 64 bit of system, that R Studio might not be support very good, or they might be giving some error. At that time, it is recommended that you should downgrade this. So you can just downgrade that version of RStudio and use it smoothly in your system. Here, while installing, you first need to install R and then RStudio, as I explained in a separate video. So R is it needs to be first installed and then RStudio needs to be installed, right? So that is the sequence of installing this. And yes, Saurabhji is asking that what is Studio here. So basically Studio is not Studio, but server he is asking. So server is nothing but like any other server. R is also providing service of the server where you can collaborate with the people. Like for example, in my organization, I want to have that R server so that all the team member can use that server for this R programming and whatever programming that we are doing into it. So that should be kept on the server and anyone can have easily access over there. So that is the facility that they are providing. Right. But as an individual user, we are not concerned about the server because server is for the organizations. Right. So there are several organizations where the department is there, then several people are working over there. So in that, they are using that. But for an individual user, we are just concerned about this RStudio. Now, I would like to ask you one question that has everyone installed this R and RStudio? Please mention in the chat box, yes or no. Okay. Madam ne install kar liya hai, Kanchan madam ne. Rishabh ji ne kar liya, Rohit ji ne kar liya hai, Sunil ji ne nahi kiya hai, Swapnil ji ne. Sunil ji and Swapnil ji, are you getting any error or you didn't get time to install it? Okay, Swapnil ji ka it is in progress. Okay, fine. Okay, theek hai. अगर कुछ प्रॉब्लम आता है तो यू कैन जस्ट रीच आउट टू मी. मैंने इसलिए पूछा कि अगर कुछ प्रॉब्लम है इसकी वजह से इंस्टॉल नहीं हुआ है देन आई कैन गाइड यू. बट एनीवे यू कैन ट्राई इंस्टॉल यूजिंग दैट वीडियो गाइडलाइन व्हिच आई शेयर्ड विद यू. एंड इफ इट इज नॉट इंस्टॉलिंग और गिविंग एनी एरर देन जस्ट लेट मी नो. एंड एनीवे we'll be starting R and R Studio practical that we are going to start from tomorrow because aaj ka hamara jo content hai in that we are going to understand about the data structure and the data types about the R. So I think then time will be over as per my experience is concerned. So from tomorrow we'll be using this R and R Studio. So make sure by tomorrow it is installed. Yes, Saurabhji, let me show you some practical things over there, then it will be very clear to you that we can work on R, then why we need IDEs like RStudio. So we'll show you both the things and what are the pros and what are the limitations of each of them, so it will be clear to you. Now, when we open R and RStudio, at that time, whatever screen that appearing in front of us, so what are those screen and what do you call this screen? So if you open R, at that time you'll have this screen, that is R console over there. Sorry. So R console is over there where you can write down your any of the code and that will be executed over there itself, right? And if you want to save those command, then you can use this R editor or R script. So both are same, just names are different. In RStudio it is there, right? So let me open my R environment and I'll show you that how can we do some of the stuffs over there and then we can go for the RStudio, right? So let me just open my R. So how can we open R? We can go to the start menu. There you can just navigate to the R. So here R and RStudio both are there. So first of all we'll open this R and there it is 4.0.0 version is there. So let me just open that. So is my screen visible, Mehul?
Yes, it is visible.
Okay, thank you. So here it is very small fonts are there. So let me just make it big. So I can just go to edit. You don't need to perform anything right now. If you want, just you can just open your screen if it is required. Otherwise, as of now, you don't need to perform anything on your desktop. So you can just watch this. What is it? And I'm just explaining the screens and all, right? So I can go to the edit GUI preferences. So here you can, you know, select all your preferences and all. So here, let me increase the font size from this 10 to, let's say, 18. So it can be visible to everyone. Yes, now you can see. So this is the, you know, description about the version. And like there's, you know, also they are mentioning that there is no any warranty or guarantee is there. So you can see here, R is free software and comes with absolute no warranty because they're giving it for free. So they are not providing any warranty behind the softwares as paid softwares are providing, right? So that is the disclaimer by them. We can just clear it out. Kaise clear karenge? So there is a shortcut which we can use, which is known as a Control L. So if I press Control L, then entire screen will be empty. So this is known as a R console. When you open this R at that time, the screen will be visible. It is known as a R console. Now, how can we use this? So let me write down this 5 and enter. Then it will, you know, again give me output as a 5. Let's say if I press 5 plus 5 and then I press enter, then it is giving me 10. Let's say if I press this 5, then multiply by 8. Multiply, that means that asterisk that we are using in the Excel. So same nomenclature here, it is applicable. It is giving us as a 40. Let's say 8 divided by, let's say, 3. Then it is giving us 2.66 and so on. Let's say if I want to make a square of some value, then 5, then this cap. So similarly, we are using in Excel also the same cap, then 2. Because 5, 2 to the power of 5. So you can see like this. Let's say I want to make 3 to the power of 5. So how can I go for this? Right. So just like that. Yes, I'm just, you know, writing this 5 plus 5 and then I'm just pressing the enter. So there is nothing to do anything in this console. So console ka benefit yehi hai ki console mein kuch bhi kaam karte ho, you don't need to run by pressing some other keys. So here I can just, you know, write down this print hello world. I can, itna likhne ke baad, I just need to press enter. Then it will print hello. So that is what currently I am following. So it is as simple as that. So this is R console. But once I close this file, let me just close this file. I save bhi kiya. But it is, you know, it will not save in some other file. So ye apna close ho chuka hai. So let me again open this R studio. Sorry, R. So see, that file was gone away. So that is not saved over there because we perform all the tasks in the console. And console mein jo bhi kaam karte hai, that is, you know, you can say it is a temporary kind of thing. Jaise RAM and ROM ka jo kaam hota hai ki wo temporary, jab aapka computer band hota hai to wo pura pura chala jata hai. So it works like that. But let's say I want to save that program, to kaise karenge? So let me just clear the screen. I can just, you know, increase the size. There might be some default option where also there, like you can set a default this font size. That also we can do like that, right? But let's say this is console and now I want to you know, create a program which I want to save and then I want to give it to you. So you are my participant, so I want to give that program to you so that you can also perform in your business. So how can we do that? So we can go to this file menu. There is a new script option is there, right? So just click on that, then untitle this R editor will be there. Abhi ye थोड़ा सा लेआउट अच्छा नहीं लग रहा है. सो व्हाट वी कैन डू, वी कैन अरेंज इट. हाउ कैन वी डू दैट? वी कैन गो टू दिस विंडोज, टाइल हॉरिजॉन्टली, देन इस तरीके से ऊपर और नीचे आ जाएगा. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू यू नो वर्टिकली टाइल दिस, देन इस तरीके से आ जाएगा. सो यू कैन राइट डाउन योर प्रोग्राम ओवर हियर. सो आई एम राइटिंग 5+5. सो हियर यू कैन सी वेन एवर आई एम टाइपिंग इट इन आर एडिटर. Let me just increase font size again so it will be more visible to everyone. Okay, so for this it would be like this only. So here, when I write 5+5 in the R editor file, at that time I am not seeing this kind of sign, like greater than wali jo sign hai, that is not visible over there. And if I press enter, then nothing is happening. Why? Because we didn't run this file or run this line. So wo run karne ke liye kya karna hai? We need to press Ctrl+R. So that is the shortcut to run this particular लाइन. सो जहां पे भी आपका कर्सर होगा वो लाइन आप उसको रन कर सकेंगे. सो यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हैं कि वंस यू रन दिस एट दैट टाइम यहाँ पे रन होगा और उसका आउटपुट भी आपको मिलेगा. हियर लेट्स से 10 × 20 मैंने ऐसा लिखा है. आई प्रेस एंटर, नथिंग इज हैपनिंग. लेट्स से इफ आई सिलेक्ट दिस, और इफ यू डोंट सिलेक्ट, आई कीप दिस कर्सर ओवर देयर, Ctrl+R. You can see all your output is there. Let me just again write down a few lines so that I can show you how can we, you know, use this file. So let's say 58 − 41, and then I run this by pressing Ctrl+R. You can see you'll get the difference of this. If I, you know, write down like 5 ⁻³, and then I press Ctrl+R, then I'm getting the result as 125. If I go and, you know, write down 100 ÷ 12, right, and then I can just simply press Ctrl+R, right, so it will give us the output. Yeah, on Mac it is Command+R. Yes ma'am, yeah, that's correct. Saurabh ji, I'll just you know, let you know that what the problem is there, because if you are seeing the plus symbol every time, then that means that syntax is not over there, like it is not completed. So that is why it is asking for the argument. So that is the reason over there. But I'll come back to you. If this problem is still there, then I'll come to that problem. Or initially, when you are very new to this R programming, at that time try to follow whatever I am writing here, because if you try to experiment something like this 5+, and then you press enter, then it will be, you know, like this only, because 5+ ke baad kya? So that it is asking for the argument. So let's say 5+ kitna karna hai, to bola 5 karna hai mujhe. So I again write down the 5 and then press enter, then it will work. So if you know don't complete the argument or that function, then it will give you the plus symbol over there. So here I am, 100 ÷ 12, and then I'm pressing Ctrl+R, then it is giving me the result of this. Now let's say, how can I identify? Ye to ek simple sa program hai, but I want to add some, you know, comments so that everyone can identify. Abhi main aapko ye file save karke itna main aapko likh ke bhejta hu, mail karta hu, then what you will understand from this? It's difficult to understand, no? So what we can do, we can mention our comment. So jo bhi hame descriptive form mein likhna hai, jo jankari ke liye hai, so hum usko kya kar sakte hai? We can just comment it out. How? So let's say hashtag is used to comment anything in the R R environment. So let's say this is example of simple mathematical operations. So here the first is, let's say some, this is for, let's say, multiplication. This is, let's say, subtraction. This is for, let's say, power. And this is for, let's say, division. So these are the comment which will not executed in the console, but it will, you know, give you insight about that particular line. And now, let's say, जब हम कंसोल में करते थे तो वो सेव नहीं होता था, वो जैसे ही हमने बंद किया वैसे चला जाता था. बट दिस फाइल वी कैन सेव. हाउ कैन वी सेव? सिंपल, कंट्रोल एस. इट इज आस्किंग फॉर द यू नो पाथ जो हर एक फाइल में ये करता है. सो लेट मी जस्ट सेव इट इन द डेस्कटॉप और मैं इसको नाम देता हूं बेसिक ऑपरेशंस डॉट आर. So .r is the extension of this file. जैसे Excel में क्या होता है .xls या xlsx होता है, Word file होता है तो .doc होता है या docs होता है, PDF है तो .pdf होता है. So similarly in R it is .r. So we can mention this .r over there and we can just save this. So it has been saved. Now we can simply just close this program. I'm not saving this image. Image that means एक बैकएंड में ये अपना एक खुद का इमेज क्रिएट करता है कि जहां पे ये सारे फंक्शंस है वो काम करते हैं. दैट इज फॉर द बैकअप पर्पसेस. सो लेट मी जस्ट क्लिक यस एंड देन लीव दैट एज इट इज. नाउ यू कैन सी हियर द फाइल इज देयर वेयर इट इज. यस यू कैन सी दिस फाइल. आई एम पुटिंग इट ऑन द टॉप. बेसिक ऑपरेशंस राइट. नाउ बाय डिफॉल्ट ऑलरेडी आई हैव सिलेक्टेड इट. It is supposed to be open in R studio, but let me just open it in a R. How can I do that? So I can just go to this R. So from this file, I can this select open script because I already that scripted file over there. So I can click on that open, and then I can select this basic operations. तो देखिए यहाँ पे ये फाइल आ गई जो हमने बनाई थी वो वैसे की वैसी. अभी मैं ये फाइल आपको शेयर करूंगा और आप भी वहां पे ओपन करेंगे तो ये इस तरीके से आपके यहाँ पे ओपन होगी. सो हाउ इट कैन बी यूजफुल, लाइक लेट्स से मैं कोई क्लाइंट के लिए आर में काम कर रहा हूँ तो मुझे उनको सबमिट करना पड़ेगा ये स्क्रिप्ट, ये प्रोग्राम या जो कोडिंग है वो. सो मैं अगर कंसोल में सारी चीजें रन करूंगा तो आई विल नॉट बी एबल टू सेव इट. तो मैं क्या करूंगा, आई विल create a script file or you know for that particular program and then save it and then send that file to my client. So now what we can do, main ye pura ka pura agar mujhe run karna hai to main pura ka pura select karke control r ye press karunga to aap yahan pe dekh sakte hain ki everything is executed right. So hamara jo function hai that all is there. So it was performed and this comments were skipped. Skip matlab unhone liya yahan pe बट उसके लिए कोई एरर नहीं दिया या फिर कोई ऑपरेशन परफॉर्म नहीं किया. इट इज जस्ट प्रिंटेड एज इट इज ओवर देयर बिकॉज इट इज कमेंट राइट. नाउ इफ आई गिव यू दिस फाइल एंड इफ यू रन दिस रन लाइक दिस देन यू विल आल्सो गेट द सेम आउटपुट. सो दिस इज द एनवायरमेंट ऑफ आर. नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज दैट नाउ व्हाई वी आर यूजिंग आर स्टूडियो देन. सो दिस इज सिंपल यू नो आर लेआउट और हाउ आर इज वर्किंग. नाउ लेट मी go to the R studio first. Let me open, go to the PPT. Resume the slides here. Yes. When you open this R studio, at that time you'll have screen something like this. So instead of one screen, you'll have this four screen. Or let's say if you are opening it for the first time, then there might be only three screen. This screen might not be there. I'll show you by opening this. So this is nothing but your, you know, you can say it is a R script or R editor that we already seen in the R. So it is similar to that, where you can, you know, do your programming and all. Here, this is console. So similarly, you can see here greater than sign is there, and whatever you write here and execute, that will be appeared here. Or you can directly write down your code in the console to execute it over here. So console में type कब करते हैं हम generally? मैं usually कब practice करता हूँ कि जब मुझे कुछ temporary चीजें करनी होती है तो मैं कंसोल में करता हूँ, बिकॉज फॉर दैट आई एम नॉट राइटिंग इन द स्क्रिप्ट एंड देन फिर वो टेम्पररी चीजें को लिखो, फिर रन करो, फिर नीचे देखो, फिर उसमें करेक्शन करो. सो दैट आई एम नॉट आई डोंट पर्सनली प्रीफर दैट. सो टेम्पररी चीजों के लिए मैं कंसोल में कोडिंग करता हूँ, बट वंस इट इज डन देन आई कैन यू नो राइट इट डाउन इन द स्क्रिप्ट फाइल. सो मेरा जो स्क्रिप्ट है दैट वुड बी फाइनल, एरर फ्री होना चाहिए. So that is editor and the script, which is similar to the R, but these two options are more. So here you can see it is global environment where you can, you know, whatever data that you are importing over here, whatever functions that you are creating, whatever objects that you are creating, that all will be appeared here. So it will be very easy to maintain. Jo R mein possible nahi hai. Jaise main R mein bhi ek cheez aapko dikhata hu ki maine yahan pe R mein, let me increase the font size. So here I am creating a object called A, और उसमें मैंने ये value store की है 5 number की, right? Now it is stored there. अभी मैं A करूंगा तब वो मुझे 5 है वो reply करेगा. जैसे ही मैंने B में क्या किया कि बी में मैंने वैल्यू कर दी 10, राइट? सो इट विल गिव मी 10 एज अ बी. नाउ इफ आई प्रेस यू नो ए प्लस बी देन इट विल गिव यू 5 प्लस 10 एज अ 15. बट नाउ देयर आर सेवरल, लेट्स से 50 ऑब्जेक्ट्स आई हैव क्रिएटेड, देन हाउ कैन आई नो व्हाट आर देयर नेम्स एंड ऑल. सो दैट इन आर दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल टू सी, और यू हैव टू यू नो यूज सम यू नो फंक्शंस ओवर हियर, और यू हैव टू यू नो यूज सम ls और सम कमांड इज देयर, राइट? Yes, so you can use ls and then open bracket close bracket, then it will give you a list of this, but you'll not have the idea that what values are stored in A and B unless and until you print that. Print that means you run that, right? But that is possible in R Studio. So let me perform same thing in R Studio. So once I do in R Studio, at that time these objects will be appeared here, so it will be very easy for me to track out that what are the variables or the objects I have created in my this R environment, and that I can trace it from the here. Another facility from this global environment section is you can import data set. So when you click on this import data set, you'll find several options to import from the Excel, CSV, Stata and all. So that is also possible there. You click on the history, so all your command will be saved in the history. So let's say by mistake or accidentally some delete option is there, or control L kar diya to sari cheeze chali gayi, so that you can retrieve from the history. And there is a connections also there, so you can also connect this with your internal server, like Spark ke sath connect karna hai ya koi aur database ke sath connect karna hai, so that can be possible here in R Studio. That is not possible in only R. So that is why we are using this R Studio. दूसरा जो benefit है कि यहाँ पे जो fourth section है, which is known as a file, plot, this plot output, package management and help. So if you see, you can you know navigate to any of your folders. So let's say if I select one particular project जो मेरे client का है, so I can you know just navigate to this. मैं यहाँ पे जाके वो project का folder यहाँ पे view कर सकता हूँ, so that I can easily access all those file in this R project, right? So that is possible over here. I can also create new folder, I can delete some of the information, I can rename that, and by using this more we can you know do many more things. So that is in the file particular menu. There is another menu called plots. So jo bhi aap graph banayenge, those old graph will be appeared here. So yahan pe maine histogram maine run kiya to uska output kahan pe aayega, wo yahan pe aayega, right? But in R, whenever you perform such kind of charts, at that time it will be appeared in a new window. So एक आपका R script होगा, R console होगा, और तीसरा है graph का अलग से window खुलेगा. अभी आप सोचिए कि आपने अलग-अलग 10 graph बनाए हैं, तो how many windows will be there? So it will be very difficult to manage in R. So we can easily manage over here. So ये सारे 10 graph बनाए तो भी वो plot में ही रहेंगे, because when we go to the plot, at that time it will give you the arrows, like जहाँ से आप ये graph में next और previous ऐसा कर सकते हैं. Then you are talking about the packages, different packages. So that also you can manage it from the here. So if you click on this packages, then you'll find out option to install those packages manage those packages? How can we update that? How can we select that? So all this can be possible over there. The fourth menu over here is help menu. So R is having extensive help, the documentation, which is very easy to understand for everyone, for non-programmer also. So let's say I want to know about, mean function. Mean, that means average that we are finding, right? So mean function is there. So I want to know that how it is working. So I can simply go to the help and search bar. I can search mean. It will give you all the documentation that how mean is working in R. So that is very strong documentation is there. And that is a viewer pane where you, whenever you perform some like web application kind of thing, then all this will be open over there. Now let me open this R Studio environment and show you each of this menu. Let me close this file. I don't want to save this. How can I open this R Studio? I can go to the start menu. I can just navigate to this R Studio, and there is a R Studio option is there. Just click on that. Yes, it is opening. Yes. So here by default, you will get three windows, right? So the first is console, similar warning that you are seeing over here as we have seen in the R. Here, this is global environment. And this is by default one, my document, that folder is open over there. Because when we install this, at that time, by default, working directory, apne choose kar leta, right? So we'll go into the detail of it later on. So let me just clear the screen first so that, I don't want this warning. I know they are not giving any warranty or guarantee for this. So let me just clear the screen by pressing Control L. So it has gone away. Now, if I want to, create a new script file, then I can just click on this little down arrow. And there is option is there, R script. Control Shift N is the shortcut for that. You can also go to this file menu, and then there is new file, and then there is R script. So there are several ways to create a new file, right? So I generally prefer to use shortcuts. So I usually press Control Shift N. So when I press Control Shift N, at that time it will be appeared like this, right? So here it is a script file, here it is a console. Now let's say humne ek file already banaya hua hai. So if we want to use that file here, then is it possible? So yes, it is possible. How can we retrieve that file? So we can just simply go to this file, then open file, and we can navigate to that file, which is there in the desktop. Name was basic operation, right? So here it is there, right? Let me open that. You can see everything is there, which we saved over there. Okay. अभी इसको मुझे रन करना है यहाँ पे तो कैसे करूंगा आई कैन जस्ट देयर आर टू थ्री वेज वन थिंग इज आई कैन जस्ट यू नो गो टू दैट लाइन व्हिच आई वांट टू रन एंड देन हियर दैट रन बटन इज देयर आई कैन सिंपली क्लिक ओवर देयर एंड देन इट विल बी रन इन द कंसोल सो आउटपुट विल बी देयर इन द कंसोल अनदर थिंग इज आई कैन गो टू दैट लाइन एंड प्रेस कंट्रोल प्लस आर नहीं है यहाँ पे आर स्टूडियो के लिए कंट्रोल प्लस एंटर है. So if you press Control plus Enter, then multiplication will be there for this figure. Then similarly, if you keep on pressing this Control Enter, you can see all your this commands are executed over there. Right. So you can also use the file which is created in R, and you can use that in R Studio also. So that is also possible. Now I was talking about some objects that we are creating. So ये benefit क्या है इसका? So let me create A is equal to ये देखिए this is also we are going to discuss, but since we are using it, let me explain it to you. जब भी कोई वैल्यू को हमें किसी एक ऑब्जेक्ट में स्टोर करवाना है तो आर में देर आर टू वेज. सो लेट मी जस्ट यू नो गो लिटिल बिट डाउन. सो वन थिंग आई कैन डू इज आई कैन गिव अ नेम. लाइक लेफ्ट साइड में जो होगा वो नाम होगा ऑब्जेक्ट का. सो आई एम गिविंग ए. उसके बाद आई कैन यूज दिस लेस देन साइन एंड डैश के साइन जो हाइफन बोलते हैं हम लोग, ठीक है. एंड देन आई कैन गिव वट एवर वैल्यू दैट आई वॉन्ट टू store. So let me give 5 and I run this, then you can see here in global environment a or a ki value kya hai 5 ye yahan pe store ho chuka hai. Now whenever I press a and just you know keep enter aur yahan pe main a likh ke usko run karunga to ye mujhe uski value hai wo retrieve karke dega. So that is one way of storing any value to any this variable. Now I can also use another. Let's say मैं b use करता हूँ. B is equal to let's say 10. So that also will work. I am just pressing control enter. You can see here b is equal to यहाँ पे 10 आ गया. Now whenever I will be running this b, at that time I'll get the value as 10. If I you know put over here a plus b, then 15 will be there. A into b, it would be 50 over there. A divided by B, it would be 0.5 over there. A rest to B, it will be this much of figure will be there. Right. So we can do like that, but we can, you know, have a track on that. Like what are the values or what are the variables that we created? That is not possible in R. So here we can see that. So that is first thing. These are the already we have discussed these two windows. Now I'll be focusing more on this environment, global environment. So here you will find out these values. Now we can click on this import data and see from text data, from Excel, from SPSS, from SAS, from Stata. So from different files you can import your data, right? So wo jab hamara session aayega data import wala, at that time we'll be using these options. We can click on the history. So see. Whatever I performed over there, that is all there. और ये मेरा पीछे का, like before starting this session, मैंने कुछ perform किया था, you can see. So ggplot install किया तब से लेके, मतलब कुछ दिन पहले मैंने use किया था, तो उन्होंने फिर भी वो save करके रखा है. I can you know retrieve all this if I want. So let's say मुझे ये जो command है, for example यहाँ से मेरा delete हो गया, यहाँ से भी ये पूरा डिलीट हो गया, तो मैं कैसे उसको रिट्रीव करूंगा? सो यहाँ पे ये ऑलरेडी मेंशन है, राइट? सो आई कैन सिंपली यू नो सिलेक्ट ऑल देम एंड मुझे कहाँ पे चाहिए, ये टेक्स्ट में चाहिए या फिर ये कंसोल में चाहिए? सो यहाँ पे सी टू कंसोल एंड टू सोर्स. सो लेट मी क्लिक ऑन द टू सोर्स. सो देखिए यहाँ पे ये वापस आ गए. सो दैट इज व्हाई दिस आर स्टूडियो इज वेरी मच हेल्पफुल टू मेंटेन द हिस्ट्री ऑल्सो. एंड इफ यू क्लिक ऑन दिस, लेट्स से आई वांट टू क्लियर दिस हिस्ट्री, आई कैन जस्ट सिंपली यू नो have this application of this broom. Broom लगाया तो क्या होगा, सब साफ हो जाएगा. So let me you know clear this. So all these things have been gone. Now if you click on the connection, you can have the new connection over there. So it is asking for ODBC, then Spark. So if you want to you know connect it with your own database, then you can use this, right? So that is also not part of syllabus. So as of now, we are not going to discuss that. But that facility is there in the R. Now let us come to this fourth section: file, plots, packages, help, and viewer. So let's say I am working on the project which is online R workshop. जो अभी हमारा चल रहा है, तो उसका मैंने एक folder बना के रखा है. So how can I access that folder without going there? So I can just click on this more. Here this three dots. Then it is asking me where to go and all. So, मैंने डेस्कटॉप पे हिरेन करके एक फोल्डर बनाया है जहां पे ये ऑनलाइन वर्कशॉप ऑन आर. तो आई वांट टू ओपन दिस. सो आप यहां पे देख सकते हैं कि ये जो डे वन का मटेरियल जो मैंने आपको शेयर किया है, तो दैट इज देयर. मैंने एक दूसरा एक फाइल बना के रखा है जो जॉब अपॉर्चुनिटीज की लिंक है, दैट इज ऑल्सो देयर. ऑनलाइन वर्कशॉप ऑन आर जो पीपीटी में अभी प्रेजेंटेशन के लिए यूज करता हूँ, दैट इज ऑल्सो देयर. एंड देर इज अनदर फोल्डर विच इज ऑनलाइन आर. सो दैट इज आई एम एबल टू सी इट ओवर हियर. इफ आई क्लिक ऑन दिस, you'll find whatever files are there in that particular folder. So this is how we can manage that those files. So let's say yahan pe ek file hai hypertension.csv, main usko agar check karna chahta hu ya use karna chahta hu, to I can you know view this file. तो यहाँ पे देखिए ये पूरा डेटा मेरा व्यू हो रहा है, राइट। सो दैट कैन बी पॉसिबल थ्रू आर स्टूडियो, दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल इन आर, राइट। सो इसलिए आईडी इसलिए यूज होता है, अदरवाइज आर के बिना आर स्टूडियो कुछ काम का ही नहीं है, क्योंकि आर तो बेस है। सो जो भी लॉजिक है, जो भी सिंटेक्सिंग है, दैट इज ऑल इट इज टेकिंग फ्रॉम द आर। बट दिस आईडी जो है वो क्या करता है, आपकी प्रोडक्टिविटी है उसको एनहांस करता है, राइट। सो दैट इज फाइल मेनू। सो यहाँ से मैं न्यू फोल्डर और ये सारी चीजें भी मैं कर सकता हूँ। नाउ लेट अस क्लिक ऑन द प्लॉट्स। सो जब भी मैं यहाँ पे कुछ प्लॉट बनाता हूँ, जैसे अभी मैं सिंपल एक प्लॉट बनाता हूँ, यू डोंट नीड टू डू दैट राइट नाउ। सो लेट्स से हिस्टोग्राम ऑफ वन डेटा इज इनबिल्ट डेटा दैट आई एम यूजिंग। सी मैं जब हिस्टोग्राम बनाया, कार्स का एक डेटा है जिसमें एक स्पीड करके एक वेरिएबल है उसका मैंने बनाया, तो इट इज कमिंग हियर। अभी मैं दूसरा बनाता हूँ इस, और ये आप चिंता मत, अभी जो कोडिंग आप मैं यहाँ पे टाइप कर रहा हूँ वो अगर आपको समझ में नहीं आता है तो डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट। आई एम जस्ट यू नो शोइंग दिस यू नो प्लॉट का क्या है, ये यहाँ पे जो प्लॉट लिखा है, सो हाउ इट इज स्टोरिंग द प्लॉट्स एंड ऑल। सो अभी हमने प्लॉट कैसे बनाना वो तो स्टार्ट ही नहीं किया है, राइट। सो डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट, आई एम जस्ट डेमोन्स्ट्रेटिंग इट। सो मैंने दूसरा बनाया तो दूसरा यहाँ पे आ गया, ठीक है। बट आई वॉन्ट टू गो टू द प्रीवियस वन, तो यहाँ पे एक एरो है, जस्ट आई क्लिक ऑन दैट, इट विल बी देयर, राइट। सो आई कैन यू नो स्वेप, कितने भी चार्ट हो उसमें मैं नेविगेट कर सकता हूँ। इफ आई जूम ऑन इट, वो एक सेपरेट विंडो में मुझे जूम करके आ जाएगा ये हिस्टोग्राम, राइट। नाउ लेट्स से इफ आई वॉन्ट टू टेक इट टू द पीपीटी और समथिंग लाइक दैट, सो आई कैन यू नो क्लिक सेव एज अ इमेज। सो इट इज आस्किंग फॉर यू नो विच फॉर्मेट यू वॉन्ट, JPG, PNG, this EPS and SVG and all. What is the resolution you want? So height and width. Then you can also, you know, by changing this, let's say I want 500 to be there. And I want it to be like this. So you can see, update preview karunga, to yahan pe niche updated preview mein aa jayega. And then I can give the name of the file. So that also I can give. Else. If I click on the save, then it will be go to the my root directory. Yeah, जो भी folder मेरा working directory होगा वहां पर यह चला जाएगा, ठीक है। I can also you know save as a PDF, so that is also possible to save. I can also you know copy to the clipboard. मैंने ये copy plot किया और अभी मैं जाके अपने presentation में इसको paste कर देता हूँ यहाँ पे, let's say just for a trial purpose, I'm pasting it over here. So you can see. ये यहाँ पे आ गया। इन एनी डॉक्यूमेंट यू कैन पेस्ट इट आउट, वर्ड में भी कर सकते हैं, ये पीपीटी में कर सकते हैं, एक्सेल में कर सकते हैं। सो दैट इज हाउ यू कैन यूज इट, राइट। सो दैट इज द प्लॉट। नाउ हियर पैकेजेस, सो दिस आर ऑल बाय डिफॉल्ट इंस्टॉल्ड पैकेजेस। व्हेन यू इंस्टॉल एट दैट टाइम, मेनी ऑफ द पैकेजेस आर इंस्टॉल्ड अलोंग विद आर एंड आर स्टूडियो। सो दिस आर दोस पैकेजेस। Let's say I want to install a new package called ggplot2. So I can click on this install. यहाँ पे कहाँ से install कर रहे हैं? तो जहाँ से हमने R को install किया है ना, वहीं पे ये सारे packages हैं. So वहाँ से हम इसको load करवा रहे हैं. So I can just type it down ggplot. So देखिए, मैंने जैसे ही type कर रहा हूँ, वैसे ये suggest कर रहा है. So I can just click on ggplot2. और ये install करके कहाँ पे जाएगा? So बोला ये मेरा जो C drive में ये जो folder है document वाला, वहां पे एक विन लाइब्रेरी करके एक फोल्डर रहेगा जहां पे ये आपका सारा पैकेजेस का डिटेल जाएगा। नाउ देयर इज अ पैकेज आल्सो, यू नो देयर इज वन फैसिलिटी इन दिस इंस्टॉल पैकेजेस कमांड, कि ये ggplot2 है उसका एक प्री रिक्विजिट होता है कि भाई अगर आपको ggplot2 यूज करना है तो ये 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 पांच पैकेज आपके ऑलरेडी इंस्टॉल्ड होने चाहिए, तभी जाके ggplot2 आप यूज कर पाएंगे। सो दैट इज कॉल्ड डिपेंडेंसी। So, जैसे मैं बोलता हूँ कि अगर आपको R स्टूडियो यूज करना है तो R तो इंस्टॉल चाहिए ही चाहिए, बराबर है। सो उसका मतलब क्या है? That means there is a dependency for R studio to install, right? So similarly यहाँ पे packages में भी ऐसा होता है। So let's say हमें पता नहीं है कि उसकी डिपेंडेंसी किसके ऊपर है, तो हमें सिंपली क्या करना है, यहाँ पे जस्ट ये इंस्टॉल डिपेंडेंसी पे चेक मार्क कर देना है। So what it will do, it will automatically identify the dependency कि भाई ये package को use करने के लिए what are the package which is required, so वो अपने आप install कर लेगा। So if we click on the install, it will start installing process over there, ठीक है। वो थोड़ा सा टाइम लेगा बिकॉज इट इज यू नो इट विल डाउनलोड फ्रॉम दैट लाइब्रेरी. और ये इंस्टॉल करते टाइम पे आपको इंटरनेट कनेक्शन चाहिए होगा. सो इट विल नॉट इंस्टॉल विदाउट इंटरनेट कनेक्शन. सो दैट मेक श्योर यू आर कनेक्टेड विद द इंटरनेट टू इंस्टॉल द पैकेज. वंस इट इज इंस्टॉल्ड यू कैन फाइंड दैट पैकेज ओवर हियर. सी ggplot2 इज देयर राइट. सो यहाँ पे एक ब्रीफ डिस्क्रिप्शन दिया है कि क्रिएट एलिगेंट डेटा विजुअलाइजेशन यूजिंग द ग्रामर ऑफ ग्राफिक पैकेज. उसका करंट वर्जन क्या है तो बोला ये है राइट. सो दैट इज हाउ वी कैन इंस्टॉल द पैकेजेस. हम इसके ऊपर फिर से आएंगे जब इसका हम यूज करेंगे हाउ टू मैनेज पैकेजेस एंड ऑल. अभी हम थोड़ा आगे बढ़ते हैं हेल्प के लिए. और ये सारी चीजें अभी मैं आपको सिर्फ ये आर स्टूडियो का जो इंटरफेस है वो समझा रहा हूँ. ये सारी चीजें हम यूज करने वाले हैं लाइक ggplot2 यहाँ पे आ गया उसके बाद क्या. So that all we are going to discuss. And then there is a help menu is there. So here you can find out the topic like as I explained, let's say mean. Is there anything about mean? Let us see. Sorry, ये जो already यहाँ पे search है उसके related अगर है तो है. यहाँ पे ये box में आपको करना है. So let me, you know, type down them. जब भी आप search में भी type करेंगे then also it will suggest you कि भाई आप ये search कर रहे हैं. So ऑटो सजेशन इज देयर वो आर में नहीं. तो जैसे मैंने मीन सर्च किया तो ये देखिए ये बेस पैकेज का फंक्शन है. बेस पैकेज यानी आर के साथ इनबिल्ट आता है. सो ये इनबिल्ट है ठीक है. मीन है अरिथमेटिक मीन. डिस्क्रिप्शन उसका दिया है वो क्या आर्ग्यूमेंट ले रहा है उसका फंक्शन क्या है. सो इट विल सिंपली स्टार्ट लाइक मीन राइट. आर्ग्यूमेंट ये एक्स लेता है. देन इफ यू वॉन्ट टू ट्रिम इट डाउन जो हम राउंड अप करते हैं तो वो आप कर सकते हैं. तो ये सारी चीजें ये आप डॉक्यूमेंटेशन यू कैन रिफर इट टू दैट. लेट्स से वो वेटेड मीन देखना है तो यहाँ पे नीचे लिंक दिया है वहां से आप देख सकते हैं कि वेटेड मीन क्या है. तो उसमें एक्स के साथ साथ आपको डब्ल्यू यानी वेट का भी वेरिएबल देना पड़ेगा ठीक है. सो लाइक वाइज यू कैन यू नो सी द डॉक्यूमेंटेशन ऑफ इट. इवन यू कैन यू नो सी द हिस्टोग्राम राइट. सो हिस्टोग्राम के लिए ये कमांड है हिस्ट. तो इसके लिए हिस्टोग्राम का. And this is graphic. Graphic is also a base package. यानी R के साथ inbuilt आता है वो है. You can see histogram वो क्या करता है. So it generates a plot. क्या argument लेता है. सिर्फ एक data set देना है हमें. And then there are several argument. इतना देने से हमारा काम हो जाएगा. But if you want to play with some other thing, like कितने breaks चाहिए, कितने bars चाहिए, कितने कौन से colors चाहिए, ऊपर आपको नाम कौन सा चाहिए. तो ये सारी यहाँ पे देखिए आर्ग्यूमेंट्स आर गिवन. जो भी आर्ग्यूमेंट है वो आप कोमा 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 करके दे सकते हैं ठीक है. सो दैट इज देयर. एंड यूर पेन अभी हमारे लिए यूजफुल नहीं है. सो विल नॉट डिस्कस दैट. सो दिस इज आर स्टूडियो इंटरफेस एंड व्हाट आर द बेनिफिट्स ऑफ आर स्टूडियो दैट वी हैड डिस्कस. सो आर के बिना आर स्टूडियो कुछ काम का नहीं है. बट इफ यू यूज आर स्टूडियो देन इट विल बूस्ट अप अवर प्रोडक्टिविटी राइट. So let me just clear it and let me go to the our PPT. Resume the slides. Yes. So this is already we have seen this file. So let me just skip this one. Yes. These are some of the things which we need to take care of it. Commands and variables are case sensitive. So ये आपने अपर केस में लिखा है या लोअर केस में लिखा है दैट मैटर्स अ लॉट. सो इसके लेट्स से हिस्टोग्राम का मैंने कमांड लिखा था तो HIST मैंने स्मॉल में लिखा था तो वो स्मॉल में ही काम करेगा बिकॉज दिस लैंग्वेज इज केस सेंसिटिव. अगर मैं वहां पे कैपिटल H और फिर IST करता तो नहीं चलेगा या पूरा का पूरा कैपिटल में लूंगा तो भी नहीं चलेगा ठीक है. सो इट इज अ केस सेंसिटिव लैंग्वेज. तो आपको वो ध्यान में रखना है. जैसे आपने कोई वेरिएबल में स्टोर किया है ए करके स्मॉल ए करके स्टोर किया है अभी उसको यूज करने के टाइम पे उसको आप कैपिटल ए करके बुलाएंगे तो वो नहीं आएगा राइट. दूसरा ये भी मैंने आपको उसी टाइम पे दिखा दिया था कि ये लेस देन और डैश या फिर इक्वल टू वाली साइन है वो वेरिएबल असाइनमेंट के लिए आप यूज कर सकते हैं. दिस इज ऑल्सो वी हैव डिस्कस. हैशटैग इज यूज टू गिव अ कमेंट. Yes, variable name may not be start with the number. So जैसे मैंने A ऐसा बोला था ना A and B ऐसा करके variable के नाम मैंने suggest किए थे तो वो A की जगह पे मैं कुछ और भी दे सकता हूँ. जैसे data है, data one है, data three है, ऐसा भी कर सकता हूँ. But it should not start with the number. यानी one, फिर हम बोलते हैं कि 1A है या 1B है या 2B है, ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए. इट वॉन्ट सपोर्टिंग टू दैट. इट शुड ऑल्सो नॉट स्टार्ट विद द स्पेशल कैरेक्टर, यानी अंडरस्कोर से स्टार्ट किया वो भी नहीं चलेगा. बीच में अंडरस्कोर यूज कर सकते हैं, बराबर है, अंडरस्कोर है, डॉट है, वो इन द मिडल, लेट्स से डेटा अंडरस्कोर एज, ऐसा अगर मुझे करना है देन ऑल्सो इट इज पॉसिबल, बट आई कैन नॉट स्टार्ट विद द नंबर और द स्पेशल कैरेक्टर. So we can also, you know, override the values. So that practical session में हम ये देखते जाएंगे. So जैसे हाँ, ये एक important है, already हमने discuss किया है, but whenever we want to, you know, assign some, you know, character value, so at that time we have to use double quote. तो आपने अगर observe किया है, तो जैसे मैंने hello world करके लिखा था, तो उस time पे मैंने ये डबल कोट यूज किए थे. आइदर डबल कोट्स और सिंगल कोट, बोथ आर वर्किंग हियर. सो यू कैन यूज एनी ऑफ देम व्हिच इज कंफर्टेबल टू यू, सो वो आप यूज कर सकते हैं. बट कैरेक्टर जब भी आप कुछ, लेट्स से हिरेन लिखना है मुझे कि ए इज इक्वल टू हिरेन, तो वो हिरेन जो लिखूंगा वो मुझे डबल कोट में या सिंगल कोट में लिखना पड़ेगा, क्योंकि वो कैरेक्टर है. उसको मैं सिंपली हिरेन लिखूंगा तो इट वोंट बी एबल टू आइडेंटिफाई दोस कैरेक्टर. So, what are the unique features of the R? So that is processing more than just a statistics. So इससे भी बहुत ज़्यादा कुछ काम करता है. R is now eminently suitable for the wide variety of non-statistical tasks, including this data processing, graphical visualization, and analysis of all sorts. R is being used in the field of finance, then natural process language, the natural language processing (NLP) जो बोलते हैं वो. फिर जेनेटिक्स, बायोलॉजी एंड मार्केट रिसर्च. सो इन एवरी फील्ड इट इज यूजफुल. इट रन्स अ कोड विदाउट कंपाइलर, सो इट विल सेव द टाइम. सो जैसे हम सी लैंग्वेज में, हालांकि मैंने बहुत ज्यादा यूज नहीं किया है सी लैंग्वेज एज आई एक्सप्लेन अर्लियर, बट उसमें क्या है कि प्रोग्राम लिखने के बाद यू हैव टू कंपाइल दैट प्रोग्राम एंड देन इट विल रन. सो यहाँ पे ये कंपाइलर है ही नहीं कि जिसकी जरूरत पड़े हमें, कि वो स्टेप ही नहीं है, राइट. सो वो रियल टाइम में थोड़ा सा काम करेगा और वो स्पीडिली काम करेगा, राइट. Setting up a working directory. This topic I'll cover when we go for the data import section. ठीक है, so ये हम उस time पे cover करेंगे. अभी हम jump करते हैं data type में. So what are the data types in R? So very quick question. What are the data types? जो आपको पता है वो आप chat box में लिख सकते हैं कि data type क्या है. Or if you are knowing some data types, then you can mention these are the data types, different data types. You can mention in the chat box. Yes, Saurabh ji is mentioning that logical, care, numeric, complex, string. Yes, Rohit ji is like integer, alphabets, etc. Correct. Yes, Sunil ji is integer, float, money, then character or varchar, nvarchar, then bit, quantitative, qualitative. Yes, ma'am. Smalling, bigint, and smalling. Okay, that's correct. So all the answers are, you know, correct. Data types defines the class of the variable. That's very true. That is the definition of data types. So it defines the class of the variable. So R कौन से data type को support करता है वो अभी हम देखते हैं, right? So basically R में ये data type है. One is numeric, the first one. Numeric में क्या हो सकता है? Integer or float, right? So many of the time it is, you know, in different languages it is denoted as a different, like integer and the float, but it is a, agar aap uski parent category dekhe to then it is a numeric, right? So that is there. The second type is a character, that means a string. So you can say whenever it is a textual form or alphabetical form, at that time it is a character or the string. So here it is known as a character. जब भी हम आर में क्लास देखते हैं तो इट शोज द कैरेक्टर क्लास. द थर्ड वन इज लॉजिकल, लाइक ट्रू एंड फॉल्स, जो बुलियन वैल्यू जो हम बोलते हैं, राइट, जीरो एंड वन. सो दैट काइंड ऑफ लॉजिकल आर्ग्यूमेंट्स आर आल्सो, लॉजिकल डेटा टाइप इज आल्सो देयर. And then a factor. So that is also another, like whenever we are having category, so let's say male and female, that is known as a factor, right? So male and female, you can also say it is a Boolean type of thing, like whenever you are using true and false. But let's say if I ask you that which is your favorite color, so I'm having five different answer. So ye five different answers jo hai usko ye R kaise as a factor wo consider karta. Factors means nothing but it's a categories, right? And then there is a complex number which is having the imaginary value of I over there. So that is there. But halaki hum jab ye analysis, basic analysis karte hai jo hamara syllabus mein hai utna karenge, to usme will be required this numeric, character, logical, factor. I don't think so anywhere we'll be using this complex number as far as this syllabus is concerned. But that facility is there in the R, right? Now मुझे आप कमेंट बॉक्स में बताइए कि व्हाट कैन यू डिराइव फ्रॉम दिस टू इमेजेस ओवर देयर. ये दो इमेजेस है उसको देख के क्या पता लगता है. यस, हाउ मच दे आर डिफरेंट. ओके, यस yes, yes, similarity in the observation in the first, and then yes, yes ma'am, or maybe same. Okay, one is same and another is mixed. Okay, so let us catch that word. Rohit ji ne jo bataya hai ki one is same and another one is a mix. So when we talk about the same, at that time it is known as a homogeneous. Homogeneous, that means it is similar in the nature. So let's say when we talk with reference to this data type, then let's say if it is a character type, then all the data are of character type. Let's say if we talk about the numeric type, then all the data are in numeric type. So that is homogeneous data, we can say. This is known as a heterogeneous data. The second one is, so which contains, you know, mixed type of data, like homogeneous is also like, sorry, not homogeneous, but let's say text is also there, character is also there, like numeric is also there, logical is also there. So that is a mix up of the data. So that is heterogeneous type of data. Why we are discussing this homogeneous and heterogeneous type of data over here? Because data structure is accordingly divided. So the next topic which we are going to cover is data structure. So that is based on this homogeneity and heterogeneity. So when we talk about this homogeneous in data, means it must be of same type. Now what is same type? Same type means either it is numeric, to numeric hai sir, character hai to character hai, logical hai to logical hai, factor hai to factor hai, and it is also known as atomic. So yahan pe aap dekh sakte hain atomic bhi likha hai. So if someone tell you that what do you mean by the atomic data type, so you can simply say it is a homogeneous type of data. That means same data type, right? What do you mean by the heterogeneous data? So it means it to be of a different type, right? So it is also known as a generic. Jaise atomic hai, waise generic hai. And it can be, you know, a mixture of this numeric, character, logical, factor, then this like complex number. So it can be, you know, any mixture of these types that we have seen now. So already we have discussed this. So I have just, kept the question to आपको जगाने के लिए कि अभी जो हमने डिस्कस किया है, सो वो आपके माइंड में क्लियर हो. बट आई होप इट विल बी क्लियर. सो देयर आर द डेटा टाइप्स दैट वी हैव सीन, न्यूमेरिक, देन लॉजिकल, कैरेक्टर, फैक्टर, एंड देन द लास्ट वन इज अ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर. सो दैट फाइव डेटा टाइप्स वी हैव सीन. नाउ व्हाट इज डेटा स्ट्रक्चर इन आर. सो डेटा टाइप इज डिफाइनिंग द क्लास ऑफ द डेटा वेयर डेटा स्ट्रक्चर इज. So let's say this number of observations are arranged in which structure. So that structure is there. So there are, you know, five structures in the R. One is vector. So vector is nothing but a simplest type of data structure in R and very useful. Another one is matrix. When it is arranged in the fixed number of rows and columns. So matrix jo hum padhte the ki 2x2 ka matrix hai ya 3x3 ka matrix hai ya 2x3 ka matrix hai. Right, so that matrix is there where there are, you know, fixed number of rows and columns are there. And then array format is there. So let's say jaise matrix mein hamare paas two dimensional data hota hai, rows and columns, but one more dimension is also there, then it is making a array form in the data. Then the fourth one is a list. So list is similar to the vector, but list consists of different types of data. जैसे vector में मैं अगर कोई vector बनाता हूँ तो it may be a numeric vector, so सारे numbers होंगे. अगर मैं character use करता हूँ तो सारे characters होंगे. लेकिन list एक ऐसी चीज है कि जहाँ पे ये सब mix में भी हो सकता है, right? So that is known as a list. And the fifth one is a data frame, where जैसे हम Excel में जो table बनाते हैं, हमने कोई questionnaire या survey किया या फिर हमारा कोई monthly production report है, so उसमें जिस टेबल स्ट्रक्चर में होता है, दैट इज नथिंग बट अ डेटा फ्रेम स्ट्रक्चर इन आर, राइट? सो बेसिकली उसमें रोज एंड कॉलम्स होते हैं, लेकिन ईच कॉलम्स आर हैविंग डिफरेंट प्रॉपर्टीज. लाइक वन कॉलम इज ऑफ डेट, तो उसमें सारा डेट का डेटा होगा. अनदर वन इज लेट्स से प्रोडक्ट, तो उसमें सब कैरेक्टर्स होंगे. अनदर इज क्वांटिटी, सो क्वांटिटी में सब नंबर्स होंगे. सो लाइकवाइज दोस कॉलम्स आर डिफरेंट, बट ऑल टुगेदर इट इज मेकिंग अ डेटा फ्रेम. नाउ just before one slide, we have understood this homogeneous and heterogeneous. So vector, matrix and array, that is a homogeneous type of data structure in R. And this list and data frame, these are heterogeneous type of structure in R, right? So now let us see the example of each one of them. Abhi main yahan pe hum slides mein example dekhenge. And then if time permits, we'll go in our studio today. Otherwise, tomorrow we are going to do practical exercise on all these data types. So see, ye vectors jo hai, wo kaise kaam karta hai? Jo homogeneous data structure ka ek part hai. So let's say these are the five observations are there. Let's say it is age. So age is there. Age naam ka ek vector hai. जिसमें 12, 10, 11, 14 इस तरीके से हमने डेटा लिया हुआ है. सो दैट डेटा वाज कलेक्टेड इन दैट फैशन. सो यू कैन सी हियर ऑल आर नंबर्स, राइट? सो एंड इट इज ओनली सिंगल वेरिएबल, यू कैन से. सो इट होल्ड्स ओनली द वैल्यू ऑफ एज. सो दैट इज द सिंपलेस्ट डेटा टाइप और द डेटा स्ट्रक्चर इन आर. सो दैट इज अ वेक्टर. लेट्स से इफ वी टॉक अबाउट द मैट्रिक्स, देन इट इज 2 by 2 or 2 by 3, or this ये जो image आपको दिख रहा है, that is let's say 4 by 3, 4 rows and 3 columns, right? So it is like that. So let's say if I'm having some data like male, female, and then I'm having data on the smoking habit of them, like smoker and non-smoker. So ये कैसा बन रहा है? 2 by 2 का matrix बन रहा है. And I'll be having some data over there कि भाई male है और smoker है वो कितने हैं, तो बोला 12 है. Male है और non-smoker है वो कितने हैं, 8 है. So likewise, this is known as a matrix form of data, or you can say, or jo statistics mein hum use karte hai, jaise cross tabulation, right? So that is bivariate analysis, bivariate frequency analysis jo hum karte hai. So in that also we are looking at some matrix kind of thing. The third is array. Array mein kya hota hai ki ye matrix hai, lekin matrix mein bhi ek aur layer add hota hai. Jaise yahan pe mere paas male female ka smoker and non smoker ka data hai, but let's say I have collected this data from different three companies. So अभी वो companies है, वो कहाँ पे मैं इसमें cater करने जाऊँगा? Because I can add only this, it is two dimensional this thing. But array क्या है? Array है वो multi-dimensional array, right? So कैसे कर सकते हैं? जैसे मेरे पास ये company A है, उनका ये information, right? उसके बाद company B का मेरे पास ऐसा एक information होगा, right? कंपनी सी का होगा, लाइकवाइज आई विल बी हैविंग दैट मच ऑफ कंपनी. या फिर ऐसा भी हो सकता है कि मेरे पास रीजन का डेटा है, सो मेल फीमेल स्मोकर नॉन स्मोकर. सो फ्रॉम गुजरात आई हैव कलेक्टेड द डेटा, फ्रॉम महाराष्ट्र आई हैव कलेक्टेड द डेटा, फ्रॉम लेट्स से एमपी आई हैव कलेक्टेड द डेटा, फ्रॉम यूपी आई हैव कलेक्टेड द डेटा. सो हाउ आई एम गोइंग टू यूज इट? सो कंपनी ए, कंपनी बी, कंपनी सी, लाइकवाइज रीजन में गुजरात, महाराष्ट्र, राजस्थान, लाइकवाइज इट मे बी देयर. सो देयर विल बी मल्टी डायमेंशनल. सो मैट्रिक्स का क्या है? इट इज ओनली टू डायमेंशन. एंड एरे जो है वो मल्टी डायमेंशन है. नाउ इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द हेटरोजीनियस टाइप ऑफ डेटा, देन लिस्ट एंड डेटा फ्रेम इज देयर. सो इफ यू टॉक अबाउट लिस्ट, देन लेट्स से मैंने पर्सन ए के बारे में मैंने कुछ डेटा कलेक्ट किया है कि उसका नाम समीर है, तो यू कैन सी इट इज इन अ स्ट्रिंग और कैरेक्टर टाइप. फिर उनकी एज जो है वो 28 है. Right, so that is numbers. मेल एंड फीमेल, और अभी तो जो ऑप्शन आता है कि मेल फीमेल एंड अदर, तो देर आर थ्री ऑप्शन राइट. सो इट इज नॉट बुलियन वैल्यू बट इट इज कैरेक्टर. सो मेल इज अ कैरेक्टर, सो द जेंडर इज इन द कैरेक्टर फॉर्म. नाउ हियर आई एम आस्किंग अबाउट देयर स्मोकिंग हैबिट. सो येस और नो, दैट इज अ बुलियन वैल्यू. सो सी हियर बुलियन वैल्यू इज देयर. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड लिस्ट व्हेन इट कंटेन्स यू नो डिफरेंट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ डेटा. बट नाउ लेट्स सी व्हाट डेटा फ्रेम इज. सो डेटा फ्रेम इज नथिंग बट यू कैन सी यू नो एग्जैक्ट द सेम एज वी आर यू नो क्रिएटिंग टेबल इन एक्सेल और एनी सीएसवी फाइल. जब भी हम कुछ डेटा एंट्री करते हैं या डेटा डाउनलोड करते हैं कहीं से, देन व्हाट एवर टेबल फॉर्मेट हमें दिखता है, सो इट विल बी एग्जैक्टली सेम लाइक दैट. सो यू कैन सी नेम, एज, जेंडर एंड स्मोकर. सो दिस डेटा वॉज कलेक्टेड. नाउ इफ यू सी यहाँ पे एक चीज ये है कि इफ यू सी इट रो वाइज, आप यहाँ से ये रो देखेंगे. लेट मी जस्ट ट्राई टू यू नो यूज सम एनोटेशन टूल. सो इफ यू सी दिस, देन इट इज फॉर्मिंग अ लिस्ट. सॉरी मैं माउस से कर रहा हूं तो ये हैंडराइटिंग प्रॉपर नहीं आ रही है, बट आई होप यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड दिस राइट. सो यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हैं कि ये समीर 28 मेल, ये जो है लिस्ट, लिस्ट को मैंने यहाँ पे सेट कर दिया. तो ये लिस्ट वन, लिस्ट टू यानी पर्सन बी, लिस्ट थ्री दैट इज पर्सन सी. इस तरीके से मैंने अलग अलग लोगों का डेटा लिया है. एंड इफ आई एम यू नो कंपाइलिंग दिस लिस्ट बाय दिस रो, देन इट इज मेकिंग अ डेटा फ्रेम राइट. अभी आप थोड़ा वर्टिकली देखिए इसको. लेट मी जस्ट यू नो रिमूव दिस एनोटेशन नाउ. सॉरी ओके. नाउ इफ यू सी दिस लाइक वर्टिकली, आप देखिए ये वेक्टर है. सॉरी सो ये जो नाम का वेक्टर है, ठीक है. सो वेक्टर में हमने क्या देखा था कि इट कंटेन्स अ सिमिलर टाइप ऑफ डेटा. सो ये नेम है, उसमें सब वर्टिकल देखेंगे तो ये सब कैरेक्टर है. समीर है, प्रीति है, फिर आगे जो भी आएगा, दैट ऑल विल बी लेट्स से दिस वेक्टर वन, दिस वेक्टर टू. एज है तो एज में सब कैसे इंफॉर्मेशन होगी आपकी, न्यूमरिक इंफॉर्मेशन होगी, ठीक है. जेंडर है तो उसमें मेल फीमेल या अदर वाला जो इन्फॉर्मेशन है, दैट विल बी ऑल सिमिलर टाइप ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन. स्मोकर में ट्रू एंड फॉल्स वाला है, वो होगा राइट. सो यस नो वाला. सो यू कैन सी आप वर्टिकली देखें तो ये इट इज अ यू नो कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ मल्टीपल वेक्टर्स, वो एक डेटा फ्रेम बनाता है. या आप हॉरिजॉन्टली देखें तो वो नंबर ऑफ लिस्ट लाइक लिस्ट वन, लिस्ट टू, लिस्ट थ्री, उसको आप अगर कंपाइल करते हैं देन वो डेटा फ्रेम बनाता है. बट डेटा फ्रेम में आप देख सकते हैं कि यहाँ पे देखिए ये एक डेटा फ्रेम है जिसमें आपका कैरेक्टर भी है, एज भी है, जेंडर भी है, लाइक नंबर भी है, कैरेक्टर भी है, बुलियन भी है. सो ऑल दिस आर मिक्स्ड इन दैट. सो दैट इज व्हाई इट इज नोन एज अ हेटरोजीनियस डेटा स्ट्रक्चर इन आर. सो दैट इज होमोजीनियस एंड हेटरोजीनियस डेटा स्ट्रक्चर दैट वी हैव लर्न नाउ. आई थिंक नाउ इट इज यू नो टाइम टू रैप अप द सेशन. सो व्हाट वी लर्न टुडे is what is R and R studio, why one should learn R, wo humne dekha. There are 11 reasons we discussed, how to download and install R and R studio, and what is the interface of R, like jab aap open karte hai to kya dikhta hai, usko kya bolte hai, kya use hai, and then what is the interface of R studio, that also we have seen, how to create new file, that also we have seen. We have also written our first program of Hello World. And we have also used, like how can we use R as a calculator? Jaise 5 plus 5, 5 plus but 11, is tarike se hum karte hai, toh how can we use that as a calculator? And then lastly, we have seen what are the data types in R and what are the data structure in R. Now, tomorrow, we are going to practice all this, lastly, jo humne dekha hai, vector, matrix, array, list and data frame, that we are going to प्रैक्टिस. सो कल का सेशन है वो इट विल बी मोर ऑफ अ प्रैक्टिस. आज तो जो था, क्योंकि ये बिगिनर्स के लिए भी है, सो मेनी ऑफ द पार्टिसिपेंट्स आर बिगिनर, तो उनको ये बैकग्राउंड देना जरूरी था. इसके लिए आज हमने आर स्टूडियो में एक्सरसाइज नहीं करवाई है, बट कल से ये सारी चीजें हम आर स्टूडियो में ही करेंगे. and you also have to perform over there. So I'll show you how to do this, and then you have to perform over there. If you are getting any error, we'll discuss that. Right. So that will be the pattern of doing that. So yes. Now, is there any other questions so that we can discuss it? Now you can mention in the chat box so that we can discuss. Yes, you can say yes, definitely. क्योंकि अगर आप let's say data frame में जाते हैं तो ये मैट्रिक्स भी आपको वहां से मिलेगा. In many of the type you'll find the matrix kind of thing also there. But ये एक समय आपको लगेगा कि अभी ये सारी चीज में थोड़ा सा अंडरस्टैंड करना या डाइजेस्ट करना थोड़ा सा डिफिकल्ट लग सकता है. बट बिलीव मी, जब हम प्रैक्टिकल डेटा को यहाँ पे इम्पोर्ट करेंगे, क्योंकि मैं अगर आप सबको पूछूं कि आपका प्रैक्टिकल डेटा कहाँ पे है, तो आप बोलेंगे कि मेरा एक्सेल में है या सीएसवी में है या फिर वो सर्वर में है या फिर टेक्स्ट फाइल में है या फिर आपने कोई अदर लेट्स से सेस में बनाया हुआ है, तो वहां पे होगा आपका जो डेटा है वो. सो बेसिकली वो डेटा मुझे यहाँ पे आर में चाहिए टू परफॉर्म एन एनालिसिस, राइट. बट अगर हमें ये बेसिक चीजें पता होगी तो क्या है कि आगे जाके जो भी हमें उसका मैनिपुलेशन करना है, नाउ मैनिपुलेशन यानी व्हाट, लाइक जिस फॉर्मेट में हमें डेटा चाहिए उसमें कन्वर्ट करना है. आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट मैनिपुलेशन यानी चेंजिंग द फिगर्स एंड मेक इट यू नो इन फेवर ऑफ आवर इंटरेस्ट, इट इज नॉट मैनिपुलेशन हियर. I'm talking about in which format we want to convert. That will be very easy if we know these basic things. Baki aap agar kuch data ke upar analysis karne jayenge, to hardly isme se koi, let's say vector hai, wo zyada use hoga. Matrix and array, wo itna zyada use nahi hoga directly. But indirectly we are going to use that. Boolean yahan pe actually hai hi nahi. Boolean yani true false, yes no, theek hai, that kind of data. So here in our environment it is known as a logical, so true and false, those two values are there. In some of the languages it is known as a boolean. Jaise agar VBA ki baat kare VBA ki, to mere hisab se wahan pe VBA mein boolean bola jata hai when we do coding in this, but here it is known as a logical, but ultimately it takes value true or false. Yes, is there any other questions that we can discuss? Okay.
Hello.
Yes.
Hiren sir.
Yes.
There was one question from participant at the beginning of session.
Okay.
The question is, I have written plus symbol and then press enter. Then every time it's showing with plus symbol.
उसका मैंने उसी टाइम पे बता दिया था. इफ स्टिल इट इज देयर, सौरभ जी यू कैन शेयर द स्क्रीनशॉट ऑन माय मोबाइल, आपको ये कैसे आ रहा है. बट अगर आपकी आर्ग्यूमेंट है वो कंप्लीट नहीं हुई है, जैसे मैंने 5 प्लस इतना लिख के मैंने छोड़ दिया और एंटर कर दिया, तो वो प्लस सिंबल आएगा और आपका क्वेरी वो कंप्लीट नहीं होगा. वो मैंने आपको दिखाया भी था. लेट मी शो इट टू यू अगेन. मेरा आर स्टूडियो ओपन ही है. सो लेट्स से यहाँ पे मैं 5 प्लस ऐसा लिख के इस तरीके से मैं छोड़ दिया, then it will not work, right? So मुझे यहाँ पे उसको complete करना पड़ेगा, right? So whatever I'll be you know giving as an argument, then it will be able to do that. Yes, it is clear there. Okay, so lastly I would like to ask you, are all you comfortable with my speed language? उससे आप comfortable है या उसमें कुछ plus minus करने की जरूरत है? तो वो थोड़ा सा आप मुझे फीडबैक दे दीजिए. तो क्या है कि और 4 दिन हमें ये करना है, तो फिर आपको फिर ऐसा ना हो कि थोड़ा सा स्लो गए होते या फिर आपकी लैंग्वेज ये होती तो अच्छा रहता. सुनील जी, यस, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर योर फीडबैक. हम यही जो तरीका है हम अपनाएंगे, यही स्पीड से हम जाएंगे और कल से हम प्रैक्टिस भी करेंगे. सो इट वॉन्ट बी जस्ट ओनली अ थियरी काइंड ऑफ थिंग, बट विल बी यू नो ऑल्सो प्रैक्टिसिंग दिस थिंग्स. और मेरा एक रिक्वेस्ट है कि अगर टाइम मिलता है कल आपको, तो जो भी मैंने डे 1 का मटेरियल आपको शेयर किया है एक बार गो थ्रू हो जाइएगा, I'm not asking you to read each and every word written over there, but at least go through it. But R या R studio open करके ये जो हमने मैंने आज जो दिखाया 5+5 और ये सारी चीजें, if you can perform that, then it will be you know boost up your confidence कि आप पहली बार इसको execute करेंगे और आपको ये answer मिलेगा, तो कल का हमारा session है वो believe me it will be excite, it will be very excellent session, क्या कि आपको भी मतलब ये मजा आएगा उसको करने में, है ना? Okay, so thank you so much everyone. आप अगर कुछ भी query है तो आप मुझे मेरे अपना जो ग्रुप है उसमें स्क्रीनशॉट के साथ उसमें शेयर कर सकते हैं ताकि मैं उसको रिव्यू करके आपको फीडबैक दूंगा. थैंक यू सो मच. आई एम जस्ट क्लोजिंग दिस सेशन नाउ. आई विल सेंड अ लिंक फॉर टुमारो सेशन बाय मेल एज वेल एज द ग्रुप, राइट? थैंक यू सो मच एवरीवन. गुड नाइट एवरीवन.